In this video, I am going to be sharing one of the easiest scalping strategy that I used to successfully scalp the markets. But before we start, be sure to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss on any of our new videos. With that being said, let's get into today's video. Scalping is a form of trading wherein a trader enters and exits multiple trades during a day to make small profits. At the end of the day, these small profits can accumulate to a large number. In fact, I have met a lot of successful scalpers who make more than six figures a year. The strategy that we will learn today is a trend following strategy. This means that we will identify the trend and look to trade in the direction of a trend. Since this is a scalping strategy, we will use the 5-minute chart to trade it. But you can also use a smaller time frame such as the 1-minute chart to trade this. For the sake of this video, we will stick with the 5-minute charts. Since this is a trend following strategy, we first need to identify the trend. For that, we will use an indicator called the moving average. Now, moving average is a simple indicator that plots the average price of the asset over a particular period of time. Different moving averages show different trends. A 200-period moving average shows the long-term trend of the market. Similarly, a 100-period or a 50-period moving average will show the medium-term trend of the market. Lastly, a 20-period moving average will show us the short-term trend of the market. Since we are scalping, we are only concerned with the short-term trend of the market. Hence, we will use a 9-period exponential moving average and a 21-period exponential moving average. This is how the moving averages look on the chart. Here, the blue line is the 9-period EMA, and the orange line is the 21-period EMA. In an uptrend, the price will stay above both of the moving averages, and the 9-period EMA will stay above the 21-period EMA. Another thing to note here is that the moving averages will be sloped upwards at an approximate 45-degree angle. The gap between the moving averages should also grow wider with each candle. This means that the moving averages should look like they are moving far apart from each other. For this chart, we can confirm that the price is in an uptrend and we will only look for buying setups. In a downtrend, we can see that the price stays below the EMAs for most of the time. And the 9-period EMA stays below the 21-period EMA. Both of the moving averages are sloped downwards at an approximate 45-degree angle. The distance between the moving averages keeps on increasing as new candles are formed. Hence, we can confirm the price is in a downtrend, and we will only look for selling opportunities. In a sideways market, we can see that the price moves around the moving averages. It does not stay above or below the EMAs. We can also see that the EMAs stay flat and there are multiple crossovers between them. There is no clear indication of a trend. Hence, we will stay away in these scenarios and we will not enter into any trades. Now let us look at the second indicator that we will use for our trading. That is the pivot points. Pivot points are simply the price levels that are calculated based on the price action of the previous day. This is how the pivot points look. Here the yellow line is called as the central pivot. It is simply the average of the high, low, and the close of the previous day. The three lines above the central pivot are called as the R1, R2, and R3 respectively. Similarly, the three lines below the central pivot are called as the S1, S2, and S3. Oftentimes, the pivot points can act as support and resistance levels. The price can reverse after hitting these levels. Another way of trading the pivot points is by trading the breakouts. Whenever the price breaks above a pivot point, it signals a strong bullish momentum. Similarly, when the price breaks below a pivot point, it indicates a bearish momentum. We will use pivot points as entry triggers in our strategy. This means that we will place a trade when the price breaks out of a pivot level. We will also use the pivot levels as our targets. Now that we have understood the indicators, let's look at the strategy. So the first step in our strategy is to identify the trend of the market. We will use the moving averages to identify the trend of the asset. Here we can see that the market was in a sideways trend on the previous day. The moving averages were flat, and there was no clear direction of the trend. The next day the market gaps up and starts making green candles. Due to this bullishness, we see that price is above the 9-period EMA, and the 9-period EMA is above the 21-period EMA. Also, both of these moving averages are sloped upwards as well. This is a clear sign of an uptrend. We will only look for buy trades. The second step of the strategy is to wait for the entry trigger. Now that we have formed an upside bias, we want an entry trigger to enter the trade. Our entry trigger for this strategy will occur when the price breakout of a pivot point. It doesn't matter whether it's the central pivot, resistance, or any of the support level. We will treat each pivot level as equal. In this chart, the price breaks above this pivot level, and this becomes our entry trigger. We will place a buy order above the high of this candle. Now the third step is the risk management. Risk management is very important when it comes to scalping. Scalping is a game of high risk, high rewards. Hence it is essential to have a proper risk management plan. In our strategy, we will place our stop loss below the low of the trigger candle. For targets, we will keep our targets at the pivot level above our entry. As you can see, the price gave us profits in this case. In scalping, we cannot expect a very good risk-reward ratio. If a trade gives us a risk-reward ratio of 1:1, then it is a good trade. Anything above 1:1 would be a great trade. But, you cannot expect low-risk, high-reward opportunities in scalping. Let us now look at a sell trade. Here we can see that the price was in a sideways trend on the previous day. But towards the end of the day the price started making lower lows. Due to this, we see that the moving averages slope downwards, and the 9-period EMA stays below the 21-period EMA. As you can see, here we had a selling opportunity. The moving averages indicate a downtrend, and the price broke this pivot point with this candle. This was a selling opportunity. We placed a sell trade below the low of this candle. But, as you can see, the price did not trigger our entry. Hence, we did not enter. So the next day we see that the price continues the downtrend by big red candles. And it provided another trade opportunity here. Here we see that the moving averages are sloped downwards, and the price breaks a pivot point. Hence we sell below the low of this candle, and keep our stop loss above the high of this candle. We keep our targets at the nearest pivot level. And as you can see, we made profits. That brings us to the end of this video. If you liked the strategy, then be sure to subscribe to our channel as we share new strategies every week. See you soon.